अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। दिस इज़ योर सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ दिस वीक। सो ओपन योर इंग्लिश ग्रामर एंड कंपोजिशन। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, होप सो यू हैव लिसन्ड योर फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस वीक एंड लर्न अबाउट ऑल। सो नाउ come to this book and open this book. So open the page number 158. Students, you will read about the parts of speech. In last lectures you have learned about the noun, pronoun and adjectives. Now comes to the articles. What are articles? A, an, and the are called articles. A, an, and the are called articles. Articles are of two kinds, the indefinite articles and the definite articles. The indefinite articles are a and an. Are used before the word beginning with the consonant sound and end with the word beginning with the vowel sound. Letters, you know, A, E, I, O, U. The indefinite articles can be used only with the things that can be counted. There are some examples. The first one, this is a table. And the third one, she is eating an apple. In first statement, a table. And second statement, an apple. Apple, because the first letter of this word is vowel sound. Okay, therefore an is used with this word. And this is a table, a table. T is a has a consonant sound. So now come to the definite articles. This is called definite articles. It is used. There are some situations, some conditions where are used the definite articles. The first one, when we speak of a particular person or a thing. He has gone to the canal for a walk. She went to the club an hour ago. Second one, when a singular noun represents a whole class. The dog is a faithful animal. Here is talking about not a single dog, not a single noun. Here is the dog. Dog is used for a whole group. Therefore, the is used with this noun. The dog is a faithful animal. Now, the third one situation, that's like with the names of rivers, seas, oceans, groups of islands, and mountain ranges. That's like the Indus is the longest river in Pakistan. The West Indies is known for great crickets. The Indian Ocean lies to the south of India. Okay, the fourth one situation, before the names of books and newspapers. The Dawn is published from Karachi. The Muslims follow the teachings of the Holy Quran. Okay, the last one, before common names, which are names of unique things. Okay, just like the moon shines in the sky. Common names but unique things. Here is a exercise. So write some indefinite articles and definite articles in this fill in the blanks. That's like the first one, dash cat is a loving animal. So we will write the cat, because here cat is showing the whole group. Okay, the next, dash table is made of wood. Dash table is made of wood. Here there are many tables in this world. एंड मेड ऑफ मै डिफरेंट थिंग्स सो वी विल यूज हेयर आर टेबल इज मेड ऑफ वुड ओके द थर्ड वन डैश चाइल्ड ड्रिंक्स मिल्क डैश चाइल्ड द चाइल्ड ड्रिंक्स मिल्क बिकॉज चाइल्ड ऑलवेज ड्रिंक्स मिल्क देयरफॉर चाइल्ड हैज बीन शोन द होल ग्रुप द फोर्थ वन वी ईट राइस विथ डैश स्पून वी ईट राइस विथ द स्पून ओके देयर आर सम अदर स्टेटमेंट्स यू हैव टू राइट डेफिनेट एंड इनडेफिनेट आर्टिकल्स यू हैव टू पुट हेयर बाय योर आउन सो द नेक्स्ट प्रेपोजिशन What are prepositions? A preposition is a word placed before a noun or a pronoun to show in what relation the person or thing indicated by it stands in regard to something. In very simple language, I explain preposition is a word. Okay, that shows the relation with the noun. Okay. Relation with the subject or between and object just like he is fond of tea he is ashamed of his behavior he was angry with me she was absent from the class so here we can understand without preposition we can't understand the meaning of sentence okay prepositions are put for the understandable meanings of sentences okay here are some sentences if you see there are many examples of prepositions you have to read all these sentences and try to understand where why and which form of prepositions used with verbs so here the next verb what is verb verb is action word okay in simple language I say verbs are action words just like sleep walk go sing eat sit all the action words called verb a verb is a word that tells or says something about a person or thing we cannot make a sentence without a verb it is therefore the most important word in a sentence for example roshana takes her meals in the afternoon the sun rises in the east She has learned her lesson. Girls were singing. He speaks the truth. Here, all the underlined words are verbs. Okay, a verb may refer to three times, just like present time, past time, and future time. So, what is present time, which is going on, and what is past time, which has been past, and the third one, future time, which will be come. Okay. So we will talk about the present tense present tense has four forms present indefinite present continuous present perfect and present perfect continuous okay present continuous tense describes an action that is taking place at the time of speaking it's like it is raining First, we will explain present indefinite. Present indefinite tense is used to express general statement and describe acts that are habitual or usual. It rains in winter. The habitual statement is like, they work hard all day. I do not take my meals at night. Habitual, usually statement, general statement, and present continuous actions which that is taking place. If we see. The fourth one example are they shining sitting idle or they sitting idle okay there is an exercise put the verbs in the correct form of the present tense indefinite or continuous so this is an example this is an exercise of all these of both tenses you have to put according to the statement. Now comes to the present perfect and present perfect continuous. Present perfect tense is used to indicate an action that has completed by a given time. Okay, and or to connect a completed action with the present. Notice it, to connect a completed action with the present time. Okay, and the present perfect continuous. Present perfect continuous tense is used to indicate an action that began in past. Here some difference, a little difference between two tenses. Just like present perfect, in present perfect work is completed, action is completed with the present. But in present perfect continuous, action that began in the past and still continue. Just like if we see with examples of the present perfect. So I have read the two books. I have read the two books. Okay, the second, she has not sent him back. She has not sent him back. But now if we see present perfect continuous, she has been playing the piano since 2 o'clock. Okay, she has been playing the piano since 2 o'clock. Action that begin in past, since 2 o'clock, and still continue, she has been playing. And then the second, I have been waiting here for 2 hours. I have been waiting, continuing, okay, for 2 hours from past. Okay students, here completed present tense. Now in next lecture inshallah we will complete past tense and future tense. So your lecture is over now. Be happy, keep smiling, and learn well, and be safe. Okay, stay blessed. Allah Hafiz. Just like with the names of rivers, seas, oceans, groups of islands and mountain ranges. Just like the Indus is the longest river in Pakistan. The West Indies is known for great crickets. The Indian Ocean lies to the south of India. Okay, the fourth one, situation before the names of books and newspapers. The Dawn is published from Karachi. The Muslims follow the teachings of the Holy Quran. Okay, the last one before common names, which are names of unique things. Okay, just like the moon shines in the sky. Common names but unique things. Here is a exercise. So write some indefinite articles and definite articles in this fill in the blanks. That's like the first one, dash cat is a loving animal. So we will write the cat, because here cat is showing the whole group. Okay, the next, dash table is made of wood. Dash table is made of wood. Here there are many tables in this world and made of different things. So we will use here, our table is made of wood. Okay, the third one, dash child drinks milk. Dash child, the child drinks milk, because child always drinks milk. Therefore child has been shown the whole group. The fourth one, we eat rice with dash spoon. We eat rice with the spoon. Okay, there are some other statements you have to write, definite and indefinite articles you have to put here by your own. So the next, preposition. What are prepositions? A preposition is a word placed before a noun or a pronoun to show In what relation the person or thing indicated by it stands in regard to something? In very simple language, I explain preposition is a word. Okay, that shows the relation with the noun. Okay, relation with the subject or between and object. Just like he is fond of tea. He is ashamed of his behavior. He was angry with me. She was absent from the class. So here we can understand without preposition we can't understand the meaning of sentence. Okay, prepositions are put for the understandable meanings of sentences. Okay, here are some sentences. If you see, there are many examples of prepositions. You have to read all these sentences and try to understand where, why, and which form of prepositions used with verbs. So here the next verb. What is verb? Verb is action word. Okay, in simple language I say verbs are action words, just like sleep, walk, go, sing, eat, sit. All the action words called verb. A verb is a word that tells or says something about a person or thing. We cannot make a sentence without a verb. It is therefore the most important word in a sentence. For example, Roshana takes her meals in the afternoon. The sun rises in the east. She has learned her lesson. Girls were singing. He speaks the truth. Here all the underlined words are verbs. Okay. A verb may refer to three times. Just like present time, past time and future time. So what is present time, which is going on, and what is past time, which has been past, and the third one, future time, which will be come. Okay, so we will talk about the present tense. Present tense has four forms: present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. Okay, present continuous tense describes an action that is taking place at the time of speaking. It's like it is raining. We will explain present indefinite. Present indefinite tense is used to express general statement and describe acts that are habitual or usual. It rains in winter. The habitual statement is like they work hard all day. I do not take my meals at night. Habitual, usually. Statement, general statement, and present continuous actions which that is taking place. If we see the fourth one example, are they shining, sitting idle, or they sitting idle? Okay, there is an exercise for the verbs in the correct form of the present tense, indefinite or continuous. So this is an example this is an exercise of all these of both tenses. You have to put according to the statement. Now comes to the present perfect and present perfect continuous. Present perfect tense is used to indicate an action that has completed by a given time. Okay, and or to connect a completed action with the present. Notice it, to connect a completed action with the present time. Okay, and the present perfect continuous tense is used to indicate an action that began in past. Here are some difference, a little difference between two tenses. Just like present perfect, in present perfect work is completed, action is completed with the present. But in present perfect continuous, action that began in the past and still continuing, just like if we see with the examples of the present perfect. So I have read the two books. I have read the two books. Okay, the second, she has not sent him back. She has not sent him back. But now if we see present perfect continuous, she has been playing the piano since 2 o'clock. Okay, she has been playing, she has been playing the piano since 2 o'clock. Action that begin in past, since 2 o'clock, and still continue, she has been playing. And the next second, I have been waiting here for 2 hours. I have been waiting, continuing, okay, for 2 hours from past. Okay students, here completed present tense. Now in next lecture inshallah we will complete past tense and future tense. So your lecture is over now. Be happy, keep smiling, and learn well, and be safe. Okay, stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.